Students, today we will discuss about the Python function. And yesterday on this particular topic, I had also subbed a video, okay, through YouTube channel, okay. And today also we will discuss few assignments that I had given yesterday on Python function. Fine. So now let us see out here. So what were the Python functions that has been given to you? Okay. So first program was there. Write a program to find the average of three numbers. Okay. By using Python function. Okay. So let us see first file. Okay. These are the easy program. New file. Okay. And to find the average of three numbers, okay, using Python function. This is our subject. Okay, so let us write it. Okay, so first of all, you know the function is an user defined module, okay, that when called will give out a specific result. All right, that is the thing. So there are two types of functions. One is parameterized, another is without parameter. That is called null parameter function. So whenever we will define a function, first of all we have to use the keyword def and then the function name. So I am taking the function name, say average. Okay, average. Okay, try to take the name of the function which is relevant, okay, and then put a colon sign. So the indentation has been done. Now what we will do, it can be done in two ways: by passing parameters, by without passing parameters. Say now, say I'm taking p one variable, okay, int, and then I'm just giving input, okay, clear, enter first number. All right. Okay, now you see out here, enter first number. So this has been done. All right, now say q equals to int, again the same thing I will write, input, enter second number. All right, now you see r equals to, I will take int, and then I will take again input, okay, input, enter third number. Okay, so that is the thing, third number, colon, and then put the bracket. Okay, so this three number has been input, we had made the input out here. Okay, now see, we will find out the average. So average equals to what it is actually, p plus, okay, the sum of the elements, p plus q plus r, okay, divided by 3. Okay, this one will calculate the average. Okay, so computing average, this is the remark I have given out here. Okay, now what we have to do, print. Okay, print, and then average is colon, okay, comma, and then give here av. This program is over. Now what will happen, you have to do the function call. So you have to come out of the block of that indentation of def average. Okay, now you have to call. So now how the call will be taken place, in this way. This is actually the what, function call. Okay, function call. So then what will happen, a whole module has been made. Whenever you will call this particular thing, so all the instructions or a group of instructions will be executed. Okay, so when finally when you will execute this one, and then choose run module over here. Okay, so it will give you the save as box. Okay, when you will get the save as box, you give a name. Say I'm giving average function. Okay, average function. Okay, this one I'm giving, fine, and click on save. All right, so here now it will ask me the number, enter first number. Say I'm giving here 10, here I'm giving 20, here I'm giving 30. Okay, so 30, 60, then 20 should be the average. Okay, so here average is 20 has appeared. Okay, so in this way what will happen, the average could be calculated. Okay, it is not a whole number, not a matter of whole number, any number. Okay, sorry, any number you can find out the average. All right, so now again, once again I am doing one set of execution, one more set of execution that I am doing out here. Okay, now you see the execution will take place. Suppose you have given 16, suppose you have given 57, and you have given 80. Okay, so 51.0, the floating point will be calculated. Fine. So in this way, what will happen, you will be able to find out the average by using a function average without having any parameter. So this is a null parameter method. Now we are doing it with the help of by passing parameter. Fine. So another program, so same thing. Okay, so now that is this thing, I am just copying from here. So I will use the same function in my next program. Okay, so what I am doing, file, it is very simple, you just highlight and press Ctrl C. it will be copied. All right, so now I'm coming over here. Okay, three numbers using Python function. Okay, by passing parameter. Okay, by passing, okay, parameter. So always you keep a documentation of your program, that will definitely will help you out. Now instead of inputting this one, you see the difference of these two. I will just why I'm doing, because I have to show you the difference. So here we have taken the input inside the function itself, but here we will not take. Okay, so what will you do instead? We will take the numbers over here. Okay, so the variables over here, so we will be able to pass the parameter. Now in this program, what was actually happening? Okay, whenever you are calling this one, then what is happening? The entire set of codes will be executed. Any function, the similar things will happen whatever language you do. Okay, so whatever language it may be. All right, that is the thing. So now I'm going back over there. Okay, so PQR. So what we'll do here, we no need to do any kind of input. Okay, what we will do finally, average, and then we will calculate the average. AB equals to what we are doing. One thing to be noticeable, that we are not inputting anything over here. Okay, because we are going to pass the parameter. Fine. So now here we will divide it by 3, and here we will display print. Okay, average is colon, and then we are putting out here AB. All right, so then our job is over. Now what we have to do, we have to input the numbers. Okay, so what we will do, we are taking three variables, a1, okay, a1 equals to int, and then input. Okay, enter three numbers. Okay, enter first number. Okay, first number, fine, enter first number, give a colon, and then see, close it. All right, then give a2 equals to int, okay, within bracket input, enter second number, sorry, enter second number. Okay, all right, so put a colon sign, just it is, you can give it for the sake of programming. A3 equals to, there is no such value of colon sign when you are putting it inside the prompt string, this is called prompt string, fine. So A3 equals to int, and then within bracket input, and then enter third number. Okay, third number. Okay, so we are inputting one by one all the three numbers, fine. So now it has been, now the function call will begin. Okay, I'm giving a remark, function call. Okay, so what will happen now, what we will do, we will call this average and pass the parameters like a1 comma a2 comma a3. Okay, now whenever you are giving this one PQR, what are these called? These are called what? Formal parameters. Okay, what are these called? Formal parameters. Okay, and when you are calling this is, you are passing what? Passing actual parameter or arguments. Okay, that are the things that you have to keep in your mind. So there are two types of parameters. One is the formal parameter, when this is actually just representing. Okay, that is three variables, and when you are calling this one, then copy from here, a1 will take the copy, whatever be the value of A1 will be passed through this Q, B, then A2 will Q, and A3 will pass through R, and then finally calculated, and it will be printed. That is the things that is called actually the passing parameter. So simply you see the difference between these two programs, again keeping side by side. Here you see, we are just inputting the value inside the function, but here we are not doing so. What we are doing, we are just writing the code over here, what are the computational steps. Okay, but here what we are doing, here actually we are taking the numbers outside of this average block and then calling them. Okay, so then passing this parameter to a1, a2 and a3. Okay, clear, these values have been passed. When this value, we will put the value over here, so it is getting a meaning. That's why it is called actual parameter or argument, but these are called formal parameter, means formal representation. Okay, suppose if you are having a wallet, okay, with you without any money, okay, just for keeping, for the sake of keeping, you have kept it, so it is just representing the wallet. But when you are putting money into it, then you are actually, that your wallet has got some meaning. Okay, that is the thing. Okay, so the here the wallet is the representation of the formal parameter, and the money that you are keeping, that is the argument. So that's what the example I want to make you understand. Okay, so average, so when you are putting say 5, 6, 7 out here, say for example, then same copy will be supplied to PQR. Okay, and here the average will be calculated and it will be printed through this statement. Okay, that is the thing. So now let us execute it, run module and then click on OK. Clear. And then we are just writing average function 1. Okay, so that is the thing. So now let us see. Okay, so this any program can be done in several ways. This is here we have done one by passing the parameter, another is without passing the parameter. The previous one actually the without passing the parameter. Now it is showing me, suppose if I am giving the 10, 20 and 30, I will get the identical output as I had got in the in our last program. Okay, so this is what actually the parameterized function and the non-parameterized function, that is the difference. Okay, so this is our first assignment. Okay, and the second assignment I am going with this one. Okay, to find the area and perimeter of a rectangle, similar by passing parameter, by without passing parameter. Okay, so what we are doing, okay, displaying, okay, area and perimeter of a rectangle, okay, using Python function. Okay, Python function. Okay, user defined function. Python using user defined function. Okay, chalo, defined function. Okay, so that is more appropriate. All right. So now similarly, def. Okay, area. Area perimeter. Okay, just I'm writing area perimeter and just not passing anything over here. Okay, put a colon sign over here. Okay. So now here I am entering L. L equals to int and then I am keeping here input where what enter length. Okay, here enter length. Okay, so then put a colon sign and this. All right, then B equals to int and then bracket input. Okay, enter. Okay, sorry, enter. Okay, breadth colon and then say this one. All right, now say here we will find out the area equals to AR, that is L into B. Okay, and then perimeter equals to what, 2 into, okay, L plus B. Okay, clear. In the book also you will get several assignments, kindly do it and show it to me. Okay, that is the thing. Print and then say area is, okay, area is colon and then you are putting out here AR. Okay, same variable and print. Okay, perimeter is colon and then you are putting here air. Okay, so that is the thing. This is just a practical demonstration, you can say. Okay, now see, I am doing the function call as usual. Okay, I am giving a remark out here, function call. Okay, and then writing, sorry, area perimeter. Okay, perimeter, fine. So the same name, area perimeter, fine. So now run module. Okay, similar, we have to save the particular function, sorry, particular program. Okay, just I am giving area perimeter function. Okay, so give always the relevant name, that will help you out, area perimeter function. Okay, so now you see out here how this is executing. Okay, so here it is, first of all ask me the length. Okay, so the length has appeared. All right, so now I am giving here say 15 and then say breadth I am giving out here say say 10. All right, so 150 and 250 will be the this thing, no sorry, 2550. Okay, yeah, so area is perimeter is what, 150, and area is also 150. Why it is 150? L plus B is 25 and 25 into 2, how it comes 150? Actually I have given the wrong variable, that's why. So it is supposed to be here P, so that's why it is showing you out here the wrong output. Okay, clear. So run and then do run module. So variable name is very very important in a programming language, otherwise what will happen, the entire output will change. So you have seen the instance over here, so always give the proper variable name. Okay, so that will actually help you out, that will be a help you out in order to get a correct result. Okay, so now same 18 I am giving and I am giving 12 out here, 216 and 18 plus 12 is 30 into 2, 60. Okay, sorry, yes. So this is actually the output of this particular program. Okay, so that is the thing. Okay, so this is the way that we had done a Python program, okay, in order to find out the area and perimeter of a rectangle using user defined function, but without passing any parameter. Now we will do what? We will do area and perimeter, okay, by passing the parameters through it. Okay, you have seen in the last program how the parameter to be passed. Okay, and one more thing, students, it is important to demonstration means like practical. After practical demonstration, if you are not using, then it will be of no use. Okay, you should implement it practically in your system. Okay, so what AR equals to, okay, L into B, okay, and P equals to say perimeter, okay, 2 into L plus B. Alright, so that is the thing. Sorry, I'm sorry. L plus B. Alright, so closed. Okay, now print what area is. Area is here AR, and this time we will not make any mistake. Print, and then perimeter is here it is P. Alright, so closed. Fine. Now we will pass the parameter after inputting the value. So we are taking out here n1, okay, nl equals to, okay, so int within bracket input enter length, enter length, and then colon, and then close, and then nb equals to, we are taking int within bracket input, okay, enter breadth. Okay, this two are has been passed. Now the function call. Okay, function call by passing parameter. Okay, this is will be done. Okay, now the thing is that we have to call it area perimeter. Okay, within bracket nl comma nb. So these are the identifiers. So now we will do execution, run module, and then say click on OK. Clear. Now let us see how this is to be done. Okay, so add area perimeter, okay, function parameter, okay, parameter, this is the name I am giving out here. Click on OK. So now you will see that it will ask me while executing, okay, there are no mistakes. Okay, so it will ask me the length first of all, then we will say 18, same thing I am doing, 18 and 12. Okay, enter breadth. So similar thing has been printed. So as we have got the output in the last program, here also we had got the same output. So that is the thing. So whenever you are entering NL and NB, this don't think this is as one. Okay, this is L. Okay, this is also L. Okay, L into B, remember. Okay, NL and B. So NL is got 18. So it has been passed through L, and NB is having the value 12, and it has been passed through B, and then the computation has been done. Okay, so for the area and perimeter. All right. So that is the thing actually that today we had executed practically, and this assignment has been given by you. If anyone is submitting, then it's fine. Otherwise, okay, you do it, you have to do it regularly. Theory. This can be considered as a theory program as well as your practical demonstration also. That is the thing. So practical programs also. So both the things you need to do. Okay, that is the thing. So this is what the two programs, you can see side by side I have kept no parameter, and here the parameter is there. So this is the difference between the parameterized and non-parameterized function. All right. So you carry on with your practical, and all the best. Thank you.